Hi, we got Abby here. I'm Louie Simmons of Westside Barbell, and we're going to give you a couple deadlift tips. This has really helped to increase our deadlifts, especially increase the technique. We're going to sit on a chair, and Abby's actually going to pick the bar up in a seated position for a couple of reps, and then a third stand up. But as you'll notice, to sumo deadlift, you have to push your feet apart, and you actually pull backwards. You want to pull your pelvic toward the bar. So by doing this in this chair, it absolutely teaches that. The bar is going to force your thighs out, and as she pulls the bar in, her sacrum will come toward the bar, and her shoulders will move behind the bar. That's perfect position. All right, first we'll demonstrate the sumo. Two sets, and then the third pull. Set, good. Arch. Notice the thighs out. All right, one more. Now set here for a count of two. Ready? One, two, go. Perfect. Most people will flare the knees in as the bar comes by them because they have weak hip and tight groin muscles. This totally eliminates that. Now we're going to demonstrate the conventional style. The same way. Here we go. Conventional style. Same method. Set back. Arch. Good. Set back. Arch. All right. Now hold it for a count of two when it's up. Sit back. One, two, go. Perfect. Perfect technique. Now, what we do, we fortify the deadlift with lots of back raises, reverse hypers, and lots of abdominal work. We do lots of leg lifts of all types, and static abs, and crunches are pretty much a waste. It looks good, but it'll make you strong. We do a lot of static abs, and a lot of leg lifts, and a lot of oblique work. You know, it's a Major League Baseball. Every time you watch ESPN, it's the most torn oblique. I mean, I thought it was impossible. Obviously, do no training in Major League Baseball because you should never tear an oblique, but they do. So train your obliques heavily. Thank you.